Good morning, everybody. I'm going to do a little tackle talk today, and it's kind of like a little bit of a follow-up of a video I did the other day. I was talking about the Pompano being a highly sought-after fish and then kind of comparing it to the Jack Crevel. So the Jack Crevel, like I told you in the other previous video, is not a good food quality table fare. So we're just going to talk about the Pompano today. I'm going to talk to you about some of the tackle and the tips that you can use, to catch them. So first of all, what we're going to talk about is, this is called a, I don't know how well you can see this. I'm going to try and make it. This is called a wiggler. It's pink in color. Pink is the preferred color for catching Pompano with any type of jigs. So this comes in a three pack. This particular brand is by Buccaneer Tackle. So it comes in a three pack, it's like $3. So it's basically a dollar a jig. So what you can do, you can use this as is. It's pink like this. Try and give you a different angle. I don't know how well you can see that. Single hook. So what you would do with this, you can cast it out as is, and then you're just going to keep hopping it. So if you ever go to, I'm going to stand up for a second to kind of give you a profile shot. I don't know how well it's going to show, but if this was my rod, you'll see, I'll do it from this angle. You'll see people on a pier doing this. They're kind of lifting. So that's what they're doing. They're basically hopping those jigs off the bottom and trying to get those Pompano strikes. So that you can use this bare. A lot of people, this is a term that many of you may or may not know. But if you add a little tiny piece of shrimp, it's called tipping. So if you want to tip this with a little tiny piece of shrimp, some people feel that that adds to it. There's a couple products out that are really good. If you're going to do that, you can cut a little square of a little piece of product. It almost looks like a piece of leather or something, but it's a light color called Fish Bites. And that's really, really very popular, like around Pensacola, anywhere up in the Panhandle in Florida. They catch a ton of Pompano up there. There's another product out there very similar to Fish Bites. It's called Fish Gum. You don't need a whole lot of it, but you could put a little piece of fish gum on here as this is plain. You could put a little piece of fish gum on there or fish bites with a little piece of shrimp, but it's not mandatory to have any type of tipping for this type of jig. It's just the action. You've got to keep it moving. All right, so that's the first example of what you can do. They make another type of wiggler. Going to be hard to get it to stand up here, but it's a two-piece wiggler right here. This is called like a teaser, basically. It almost looks like a little fly. I'm going to stand up, try and get closer so you can see this, and you just tie it up here and you do the same thing as the previous wiggler. This comes in a pack of one, and this is also currently like $2.99. So everything I'm going to show you here today is, I think one's like $3.49. But anyway, same process. You can tip it if you want right here. Do not mess with the teaser. Just let that little feather tail do its thing. So that's very productive too. So here's probably the most productive type jig that a lot of people like to use. This is a lot of the public piers. When I said the public, like the municipal piers. Ooh, some words are tough for me. Anyway, this is called a banana jig. So what I was trying to tell you is this banana jig has a treble hook on it. A lot of the municipal piers will not let you use treble hooks in Florida. Now, I'm not saying all of them, but a lot of them, because they try and help preserve the pelicans. Anytime you're going to have a big public pier, there's going to be a lot of pelicans. They're going to go after your baits and stuff like that. So, three hooks in one little setup like this called a treble hook is going to create havoc for a pelican. But you can use these off the beaches. You can do very well with this. So it's got a little curve in it. Once again, this is pink. I don't know how well you're going to be able to see this. I'll try and move it a little bit. It's got little bits of mylar in there, glitter, whatever you want to call that. And that's a very, very good method for catching pompano. Somebody told me a couple years ago, and I have yet to see or hear this. I even tried contacting the FWC, but someone told me you can no longer use treble hooks on banana jigs to catch pompano. And I've searched high and low, and I think someone just got bad information. So I'm just telling you what I heard. I think they were wrong, but just double check with FWC just in case you're worried. So anyway, so different states may have different regulations. I think that was inaccurate information because I checked everywhere. But, and the person that was telling me this is a person that was making single hook wiggler type jigs for pompano. So they could have known. I don't know. I couldn't find the information anywhere. So now we're going to move on to the next type. This is called a skimmer jig. This type is made by Buccaneer Tackle, and it's basically a small bucktail with a pink head. Pink is the desired color to catch pompano. So that pretty much ends the video. There's a lot of different ways, but the best method is just to keep hopping your bait. So pink is good. I will say chartreuse is pretty good. That's probably the next best color. So that's it. That's your tackle tip of the day from Jailbait and Tackle. So y'all have a great day, and I'll be talking to you soon.